Hello traders and welcome to another video review. Today is Friday, October 8th, 2021. Let's take a look at the Forex calendar because today is the first Friday of the month, which means we will be quite busy because there is non-farm payrolls data release from the US, of course. But let's get the first thing. Data from Japan were released already overnight, but there is nothing that much interesting here. We got market services and composite PMI data from China. As you can see, both of them had beat the expectations and the previous readings, 53.4 and 51.4 respectively. So good data from Chinese economy. During the London session, there is nothing interesting here in terms of the data release, but during the New York session, as I said, we have unemployment rate and non-farm payrolls scheduled for release as usual, 2:30. Moreover, there is a change in private payrolls, change in manufacturing payrolls, and average hourly earnings data to be released as well. So that's the data from the US for today. And from Canada, we got unemployment rate and employment change, part-time employment change, and participation rate. All of this labor data are scheduled for release at 2:30 as well. Please notice that unemployment rate in the US is expected to drop from 5.2% to 5.1%, and the non-farm payrolls are expected to beat the expectations. I mean, to beat the previous data, of course, the expectations are 490,000, and previous reading was 235,000. So as you can see, almost a double, over a double non-farm payrolls should be created for the previous month according to the expectations. We will see if the actual number will be this figure. So very busy day today. I think that there might be nothing going on until the non-farm payrolls release, as usual, accordingly. So let's just take a look at whether the good Chinese data have an impact on Australian dollars. And we are going to start with the daily time frame chart of the Australian dollar. As you can see, we are still trading below the trend line. We are still trading below the recent swing high at 7,483. We bounced from 7,171. That's good, but the local technical resistance, 7,318, has not been violated yet. We tested yesterday, but today we are going a little bit lower. So that might be the key short-term technical resistance for Australian dollar. All right, so please pay attention to this level, because eventually, let me just copy one line. The next technical resistance might be somewhere around, let's say, 7,371 pips. So please keep an eye on this level as well. Of course, the key technical resistance is still 7,415 and the high at 7,483. The momentum here is kind of a neutral. Recently, it broke towards the positive net territory, but the reading was 53 points on the RSI, so that's not that much. And we are back straight on the neutral level. So market is waiting apparently for the NFP payrolls data. So let's take a look at the US dollar index. This is something that will interest us the most. As we can see, of course, there is an uptrend, including the breakout above the 93.70 level. So in the background, there is a move up. Okay, so we are inside of the uptrend. There you go. Right, if 94.47 is violated, the next target is 94.71. So this is the current situation of the US dollar index. And as you can see here, position of the RSI is in favor of bulls. Positive territory, strong momentum, 66, 67 points, very strong momentum to the upside. So that bounce from 93.70, the key short-term technical support had been very positive for bulls. As we can see, we are still on the way up. We are continuing the move up and we expect higher prices. We expect higher levels to come in the nearest future. I would like to show you a US dollar to Japanese yen chart here, because if you take a look at this, then you will see that this market, there is kind of a cup in a handle pattern here, a little bit skewed, but take a look at this. This is the cup pick and this is the candle. Yeah, does it look familiar to you? It might be a little bit, it's not a textbook example of the cup and a handle, but looks kind of a familiar here, and it's a continuation pattern, which is very important for this pattern to be placed accordingly. This is a cup, like a cup of coffee, and that's a handle. Okay, so if this is a continuation pattern, then it means we are going to reach way, way, way higher on the US dollar to Japanese yen, because that would mean this zone here between 111.71 and 112.25 will be violated very, very, very shortly. And that's not a problem for bulls, because if this is a cup and a handle formation, let me take a look for another target. Yes, yes, of course, another target is somewhere around the level at least 114.57. There is of course the local technical resistance as well from the highs of the 2000, and this is 2019, so that's like 112.43. okay, fine, but that's not the target for this cup and handle formation. This is not a target for bulls. Okay, the target would be 114.57. So I would rather see this one coming than any lower level. So we have this zone here, and please consider the fact that this is a bullish formation. We are going higher on the US dollar to Japanese yen, way higher towards 114.57. So this scenario is valid as long as we are not back under 110.91 in the short term, and in the long term, as long as this move up here is not clearly reversed and the level of 109.08 is not clearly violated. As long as it's not, we are going, most likely we are going up here. Okay, so S&P 500 and the gold. How will gold react? The spot gold market, as you can see, is positioning itself for the data release. We broke above this upper channel line, and we are like a lying on this upper channel line, sorry, and of course not much is going on here. The volatility is like $20, not even $20 or something like this, so rather low. And the market is waiting for the data, and the data might trigger some very interesting moves here on the gold market as well. So please keep an eye on this market. Let's take a look at the US dollar to the Canadian dollar, because of the data here, not much is going on here on the US dollar to the Canadian dollar. We are approaching the 50% Fibonacci retracement again, 1.2480, and if we break it, then of course we have another target, 61% of the Fibonacci retracement, 1.2369. so please keep an eye on this level as well, because we might see this level to come very, very soon. Please notice that this recent breakout above that trend line, okay, from that high, had been very, very successful. So this is not applicable anymore. Well, there's a big levels down up there, so I will not draw any kind of a line right now. It's not necessary, but we have our channel, and as you can see, our channel had been working quite nicely. But recently, after we failed to make another higher high, the market moved out of the channel, felt out of the channel, and now it's kind of a look, it's starting to look bearish simply. Okay, so please, 50%, 61%, the next targets for bears on the US dollar to the Canadian dollar after the NFP payrolls trigger the move. Thank you very much for watching this analysis. I hope it helped to prepare before the NFP payrolls, and I hope I see you guys next time. So take care and bye bye.